A 1,000 ml fluid containing 500 milligrams of Keflin is given at a flow rate of 125 mils per hour. How much drug is given per hour? So our ultimate goal here is to determine the amount of drug in mils that is given per hour. To do this, we have to take the total amount of drug and divide by the total time. But notice how here we're not given the total time. So before we can determine how much drug is given per hour, we have to find the total time by taking the total amount of fluid in milliliters and dividing by the flow rate in milliliters per hour. So we'll first find the total time, and then we'll find the amount per hour. So again, for the first step, we'll find the total time, which should be 1,000 milliliters, the total amount of fluid, divided by the flow rate in milliliters per hour, which is 125. Well, 1,000 divided by 125 is equal to 8, so the total time is 8 hours. And now that we have the total time, we can determine the amount of the drug given per hour. We'll take the total amount of drug in milligrams, which is 500 milligrams, and divide by the total time in hours, which we now know is 8 hours. This quotient will tell us the number of milligrams per hour. So if we're allowed to use a calculator, we can just take 500 and divide by 8. So the amount of drug given is 62.5 milligrams per hour. Just in case you're not allowed to use a calculator, let's go ahead and perform this division on the next slide. We would have 500 divided by 8. There are 6 8s and 50. 6 times 8 is 48. We would subtract. This difference is 2. Bring down the 0. There are 2 8s and 20. 2 times 8 is 16. We subtract. This difference is 4. We need to keep going, so put our decimal point after the 500, move it up to the quotient, and now we can add zeros to the rather decimal point without changing the value of 500. So we can put a 0 here and bring it down, and notice there are 5 8s and 40. 5 times 8 is 40. We subtract, this difference is 0, so we're done. The quotient is a terminating decimal, and the quotient is 62.5, which we also found on the calculator. I hope you found this explanation helpful.